Can someone tell what the derivative of function f of x is? A derivative. This is d by dx of f of x. What is the definition of this? This one, right? Limit delta x tends to 0. F of x plus delta x minus f of x divided by delta x. See, this can be written as this one, x plus delta x minus x, right? The rate of change. This is called as rate of change of f of x with respect to x at the point x. Like that, you can define the derivative at x, or you can call it like a slope. And one more thing, gradient of a function. Suppose x bar is a vector, x1, x2, and so on, xn. And consider some function of x bar, function of x1, x2, up to xn, some function. Now the gradient of this one. Is a vector. The partial derivatives. Dou f by dou x1. Dou f by dou x2. And so on. Dou f by dou xn. The n cross 1 vector. The gradient. Here the partial derivatives is function of x bar, x1, x2 up to xn, function of several variables. Okay, let's draw some continuous function. Let me know which one is maximum and which one is minimum point. I'll try to name the points. Can you just tell me which one is minimum point out of them? Minimum point. Yeah, one of you can answer. You can just look into this figure and tell me which one is the minimum point out of them. Minimum.
4.
Well, that is 4, right? This corresponds to minimum. For example, let's have the notations. This is some x1. The concerned one is f of x1. And if you call this like x2, the concerned one is f of x2. If this is x3, the concerned one is f of x3, x4, f of x4, x5, f of x5, like this. They are just notations. This is x7, f of x7. It's a minimum point, right? We have minimum at x4. Minimum at x4. Okay, where is the maximum point at? Okay, where is the maximum of this function? It's x7. At x7, you have maximum. The maximum point is at x7. Minimum point is at x4. And I'll try to give some definitions. Local minimum and global minimum. Local minimum means in the neighborhood, that point should be minimum. Global minimum means for that entire function, that should be the minimum point. Local minimum means in the neighborhood, that should be minimum. Can you see what are the local minimums and what are the global minimums in this? See, local minimum means if you try to deviate from that point a little bit, either this side or that side, that should be bigger compared to that point. That's called as local minimum. Global minimum means that should be minimum for this entire span, entire duration. That's a global minimum. Local minimum means if you try to deviate slightly from that point, either left side or right side in this case, any direction, that should increase. Then you can call it like local minimum. Yeah, which one are local minimums in this? Can you say this is local minimum? Yeah, what are the local minimums in this?
One, two, six,
right? These are the local minimas, and this also called a local minimum. 4 also. This also having the same property, right? If you try to deviate from this point slightly, this side or that side, that will increase, right? The local min. Strict local minimum. You can call them like strict local minimum. Actually, local minimum means if you deviate this side or this side by some amount, little bit amount also, then if that is not less than this one, then you can call it like local min. Strict local minimum means that should increase if you go this side or this side. And this is the same thing, right? If you go this side, that's increasing. If you go this side, that function value is increasing, right? F of x is increasing. Same thing for this one. If you go this side, function is increasing, right? That f of x is bigger compared to this one. Same thing this side also, like this. These are the local minimas in this. Out of which, what is the global minimum? Someone already said, right? It's a global minimum. At x4. X4. At x4, you are having a global minimum. This is global minimum also. Okay, similarly, can you define local max in this? Local maximum. Okay, let me. Yeah, what are the local maximum in this at least? See, if you deviate from this point, this side or this side, that is decreasing, right? Then you can call it like strict local max. It's 3 the local max. And similarly, 5. If you deviate this side or this side, any direction, that's decreasing, right? 5 also local max. And 7 also local max. Out of these, 7 is the global max. This is not only local max, this is a global maximum also. It's 7.7 at x7. Is a local maximum and global maximum also, this 0.7. Similarly, you are having one more local max here. Some local max here, right? Suppose if I say that you have a Laplace function, some Laplace function like this. Okay, what is your target in this case? Do you want to minimize the Laplace function or do you want to maximize the Laplace function? I am calling f of x as a Laplace function. In general, do you want to minimize the Laplace or do you want to maximize the Laplace? Laplace function or cost function? Whatever you want, you can call. Yeah, which one is true? Do you want to minimize or do you want to maximize this?
Minimize.
You want to minimize, right? It's a Laplace function. Always you are trying to minimize the Laplace or you are trying to minimize the cost. That's not your goal, right? In majority cases. You want to minimize this function. That's what your target. You are going to get minimum at this. Some x star, you are going to get minimum point at this. The concerned thing is f of x star. The global minimum, right? The global minimum. You have local minimums. This is one local minimum. This is another local minimum. It's not only local minimum, this is global minimum also. Your actual target is you need to achieve this one. That's what your target. You need to minimize your loss as much as possible. It's a good solution for you, right? Okay, that's fine. Suppose you have a function like this, it's a convex function. Yeah, this is homework for you. You can try to learn what is convex function. Suppose if you have some convex function like this, this is x versus some f of x, function of x. Okay, what is this slope? Is it positive or negative? Let me consider some points. Some x1, x2 and x3. What is the slope at this point? Is it positive or negative? Okay, I'll try to ask you one question. Okay, which one is having positive slope? This case 1 or case 2? You have seen the definition of slope, right? If you want to see the slope at x1, slope at x1, what you are going to do is f of x1 plus delta x minus f of x1 divided by delta x, limit delta x tends to 0. This is the definition of f dash of x1, slope at x1. Similarly, if you want slope at x2, limit delta x tends to 0, f of x2 plus delta x minus f of x2 by delta x. Similarly for this one. Okay, is it positive negative or zero, this value in this case. You can see, right? If I say this one x1, my x1 plus delta x is somewhere here. This is x1 plus delta x. And this value corresponds to f of x1. And this value corresponds to f of x1 plus delta x. This height. From this, can you guess whether this is positive or negative? F dash of x1. Which one is bigger? This first value is bigger or second value is bigger? You can see this, right? Is the difference... Okay, this is bigger, right? And then the difference is negative. This minus this is negative, right? It's a negative. Then f dash of x less than 0, right? Negative means, negative slope means decreasing function. You can see, this is less than 0. It's a decreasing, right? At this point, that is a decreasing. If you increase x, this function is decreasing. It means slope is negative. Suppose if you consider this point, this is x3, and let's say, this is x3 plus delta x. Now, f of x3 is smaller than f of x3 plus delta x. If you increase x at this point, that is increasing, that's increasing function, right? And the slope is positive. You can try to substitute in place of x1, go for x3. This minus this is positive, right? This is bigger than this one. This minus this is positive. In this case, you are going to have greater than, right? Okay, this increasing means greater than, decreasing means less than, f dash of x less than 0. If you increase x and f of x is decreasing, then you can say the slope is negative, f dash of x is negative. It's like this case, right? F dash of x1 is less than 0. In this case, this is f dash of x3 greater than 0. It's increasing, right? If you increase x, that's increasing. Function is increasing. Then what about this point? What is the slope at this point? Okay, let me redefine that one. You might have studied this in your PUC level. Can you define like this? Let me call this like some x3. This is x versus f of x. The f of x. F dash of x3. This is the derivative at x3. Equal to slope of tangent. Is it okay, this statement? The slope of this tangent is a tangent line at this point x3 to this curve. The slope of this tangent is same as derivative of this function at x3. These two are same. The definition, right? That you studied in your PUC level, basic geometry. So about the tangent at x3. And is it positive slope or negative slope? Let me introduce this also. This is x-axis, positive x-axis, this is negative x-axis, this is positive y, negative y. And if you are having a line like this, is it having पांच डू स्लोप और नीडू स्लोप इस लाइन लाइन वन से लाइन टू इस लाइन थ्री ओके व्हाट अबाउट लाइन वन इज इट हैविंग पॉजिटिव स्लोप और नेगेटिव स्लोप See, we defined it already. As you increase x value, the constant y value, that function value is increasing. Then you can say the slope is negative. If you increase x value and that function also increasing, then you can say that's positive slope, right? If that is not changing at all, then you can say zero slope. Slope is zero. Yeah, is it positive or negative slope? This one. Is it greater than zero or less than zero?
Less than
zero. Slope of this. Is less than zero, right? It's negative slope. We can see if you increase this one, that's decreasing, right? It's a decreasing function. Increase x value is decreasing. Then what about the slope of this? Is it positive or negative?
Positive,
right? If you increase this x value, that's increasing, right? The positive slope greater than zero. And what about the slope of this? This constant, this x-axis, that's zero, right? It's not changing at all. It's not changing at all. This slope is zero for this. Okay. Now let's try to interpret here. Okay, what about this? Is it positive slope or negative slope? Oh, this is positive slope, right? In this case, we are getting greater than zero for this. The positive slope. Because you can see, right? The function also increasing. If you increase x coordinate, this increasing, right? At this point. Similarly, this tangent also increasing, right? Same behavior for your tangent also. Okay, let me have a tangent at this point. Some x1. Then what about the slope? What is the slope of this tangent? Is it positive or negative? Slope of this. Less than zero, right? The slope is negative here. Slope is positive, this is increasing. It's decreasing, right? The tangent is decreasing as you increase x. Similarly, this function also decreasing as you increase x, right? The slope is negative. Then what about this point, this bottom point? What is the slope of this tangent at this x3? Slope of tangent or derivative of this function at x3. Oh, x2, right? Let me call it like x2. A dash of x2. What is this? Zero, right? This is zero. You can see this is a constant, right? This tangent is parallel to x coordinate. Parallel to x coordinate, right? It means slope of this at this x2 is zero. It's a constant, right? Similarly, can you guess this? What are the slope of the tangents at these points? Yes, what are the slopes? What is the slope at this point? What is the slope at this point? You can see, right? The tangent is parallel to x coordinate. The slope of this one is zero. If you say x1, f dash of x1 equal to zero, you call this like x2, f dash of x2 equal to zero. Where this is parallel x coordinate, right? This tangent. And if you call this like x3, f dash of x3 equal to zero. And if you call this like some x4, f dash of x4 equal to zero. From this, what can you say? Are you getting anything from this, these observations? See, you can try to correlate this one with this. What are you getting from that side and this side? Yeah, can you briefly summarize that one? What's happening here? Slope or derivative function at local minima or local maxima equal to zero, right? The derivative at local minimas or local maximas is equal to zero if that is a continuous function. It's a continuous function. If that is a discrete function, derivative won't exist, right? It's a continuous function. Slope or derivative of the function at local minimum or local maximum is equal to zero. From this, you can say if that is a continuous function and if f dash of x equal to zero implies some x1, x2, x3, for example. If you have some function, first derivative equal to zero, and these are the solutions you got, then these solutions might be local min or local max. See, some of them might be global min, global max. Might also be global min or global max. You see, by global min, global max also called as local min, local max, right? Okay, one of you can answer. You have given me some function f of x, function of x, and I asked you to find what is the local minimum for this. Find local min, local max, and so on. How to do? F of x is a differentiable function. Yes, how to find local min or local max? Function f of x is given to you.
Differentiating the function equals to zero.
Yes, you can find the first derivative and equal to zero. From there, you can get either local min or local max points. That can be, but you can't guarantee whether it is local min or local max. One of them at least. Up to that, you can guarantee, right? Suppose there is a convex function like this. It's a convex function. And if you found the derivative, and if you equate to zero, whatever the point you are going to get from this, that solution x star is called as global min by default. You can look into this figure, right? It's a global minimum. Because, see, you are having only one solution, right? Only one point where your slope is zero. This is that point, right? Remaining all points are having non-zero slope. These points are having positive slope. And this side points are having negative slope. Where this is decreasing up to this. This is increasing after that, right? Only one solution you are going to get. And that is called like global minimum. If you want, you can call it like local minimum also. In this case, these two are same. Local min, global min, both are same. Because you are having only one minimum, right, with this. That is a convex function. Okay, let me ask some basics of gradient descent algorithm. Gradient descent optimization algorithm. Let me consider some function like this. The x versus f of x. I want to find the solution for this. I want to find the minimum point for this. My target is, I want to find minimum point for this. What I am doing is, I try to start randomly with some point. For example, I try to call this like minimum point x naught. Some initial guess. I try to guess that x naught might be the minimum point, and f of x naught might be the minimum. Like that, I will feel. Okay, I'll try to write some update rule. You can try to guess from there. Okay, which one is true? What is the best update rule? Is it plus or minus? Where alpha is positive, alpha greater than zero. If you want to approach to minimum point, which one is the best update rule? It's an iteration number. For example, see, I am starting with point x naught somewhere here. It's some x naught point. And next time I want to update that, let me consider k equal to 0 in this, k equal to 0 in this. It means x1 equals to x0 plus alpha into f dash of x0. And if you do in this, x1 equals to x0 minus alpha into f dash of x0, k equal to 0 in this. In the iteration number 1, in the first iteration, this is called as iteration. The first iteration, I want to use either this or this, whichever is correct. Okay, which one you feel right one, this first or second? You want to approach to this point, that's your target. You want to approach to x star, this is a minimum point. That means x1 should approach towards this, right? That should not go away from this. That should go like this. This is the right one, this is the wrong one, right? X1 should go this side after updation. That should not go away from x star. This is the wrong direction. If you are expecting your x1 to be closer to x star, will you go for this first one or second one? Yeah, which one is correct? Here alpha is positive, alpha greater than 0. So forget about this. Will you prefer to go right side or left side? See, what you are doing is randomly you picked some starting point x naught. You thought that this might be the minimum point, but after that you realized that you need to update that. You want to update that so that you can approach to that global minimum point. That's what your target. Will you prefer to go to right side or left side? At least from this figure you can guess, right?
Right side.
Right side, right? You want to approach to minimum point. If you go this side, you are approaching to x star, right? That's what your target in this case. Now, which of these equations are you trying to approach to x star? First or second?
Second one, sir, I think.
Why second one?
Because slope is decreasing.
Okay, decreasing slope means f dash of x naught is negative, right? In this case, f dash of x naught, in this example, it's less than 0. Slope is negative means, and this is positive, alpha is positive. Minus of minus, this will become plus, right? That means your x1 will be somewhere this side, right? This will be your x1, like that, right? If you apply this equation, it'll go this way, because slope is negative and this is positive. You'll get x naught minus something. You'll go this way, right? It's a correct one. It means this is correct, this is wrong. This is wrong, right? It's a correct one. Let me cross check with this also. We just cross check it for decreasing side, right? Let me cross check in the increasing side also. For example, you are at this point. Let me consider after kth iteration, you landed up at this point, for example. Now you want to update. We are thinking that this might be the good option for you, right? Minus is good compared to plus. Let me cross check here also. Then what about the slope at this point? F dash of xk. Is it positive or negative? It's increasing, right? At this point xk, that's increasing. This is positive. Slope is positive. Now, if you try to apply this expression, xk minus something positive, that means this is decreasing, right? Your xk minus 1 might, xk plus 1 might be somewhere this side, which is approaching towards your x star, right? Trying to approach towards your x star. Xk plus 1. This is the right direction, right? It means this is the correct one. This is the wrong one. This is wrong. And this is the correct one. It's the final one. Okay, what about this point? Suppose you are at this point. What is your next updation? Suppose, let me say, this is your xk, for example. You are at this point. Then what happens to this one, f dash of xk, in this case? What is this one?
Zero.
This is zero, right? Slope is zero at this point, at the minimum point. In this case, you are going to get xk minus 0. Same as xk, right? It remains same. Xk plus 1 is same as xk at this point. Once you reach to minimum point, xk plus 1 is same as your xk. This won't update at all, right? When you reach to minimum point. At that point, you can stop. You can stop iterations, right? That's what you are going to do. This is known as gradient descent algorithm. Gradient descent algorithm. Can you guess why this is gradient descent algorithm? There is meaning in the descent, right? Why this is descent? Gradient means slope. Gradient is nothing but slope. Gradient descent algorithm means, yeah, what is that meaning? Yeah, you can do it as part of homework. Try to understand what is the meaning of this one. There is a meaning, right? In this. Okay, this is called a gradient descent algorithm, which will be useful to approach to the minimum point. If this is a loss function, you are trying to minimize the loss function, right? By adjusting this parameter x. Suppose if you are having more than one parameter with you, that means function of x bar, for example, where x bar equals to x1, x2, function of several variables or several parameters. More parameters are there. In this case, your gradient descent algorithm will be xk plus 1 bar equals to xk bar. And what should be this one? Minus alpha into gradient operation del x bar f of x bar. It's a gradient operation where del x bar of f of x bar equals to, and it's a gradient at xk bar, right? Dou f by dou x1 and dou f by dou x2 and so on, dou f by dou xn. It's a vector, right? Okay, let me try to have some other notation. Let me have k plus 1 somewhere here. Iteration k plus 1, like that you can feel. This is iteration number k. Because you want to have index for this also, right? In order to avoid confusion, and then to keep this iteration number on the top, like this. This derivative at xk. The dimension of this one is n cross 1. The dimension of this one is n cross 1. The dimension of this also n cross 1. It's a gradient descent algorithm. And this alpha is called as learning rate parameter. This alpha. This is called as learning rate or learning parameter. Like that you can call this alpha. Okay, what happens if alpha is more or less? Let me try to see this. Suppose this is x and this is f of x. Let me see you are at this point. at kth iteration, you are at this point. So let me change the notation. Xk, right? At kth iteration, you are at this point. Xk. Now, what you are doing is, you are trying to apply this. Xk plus 1 equals to xk minus alpha into f dash of xk. Yeah, this thing you want to do. Suppose alpha equal to 0.1, for example, alpha equal to 0.1, then what's happening here is, yeah, what is the slope at this point? Is it positive or negative? This slope. Okay, you can answer. Is it positive or negative? The slope at this point. Decreasing, right? It's a negative. The slope is negative. Now, what's going to happen is, minus of minus is plus. Your xk plus 1 might be somewhere here. Suppose, instead of 0.1, if I make it like 0.2, then what's happening? Will it go this side or this side? Which side that will go? If I make alpha equal to 0.2. See, if I make alpha equal to 0.2, see, almost double increment, right? Almost double increment compared to earlier one. Earlier increment is minus 0.1 into f dash of xk. Now the increment is minus 0.2 into f dash of xk. This is double increment compared to earlier one, right? If this is the increment, you might be landed up somewhere here with alpha equal to 0.2. This is your xk plus 1 with alpha equal to 0.2. This one is xk plus 1 with alpha equals to 0.1. Now this one corresponds to x star. Now which one you feel good for you? Alpha equal to 0.1 or alpha equal to 0.2? Which one is approaching to x star faster? Alpha equal to 0.1 or alpha equal to 0.2? Faster means you can see, you are at this point initially. If you use alpha equal to 0.1, your xk plus 1 is this. If you use alpha equal to 0.2, your xk plus 1 is this one. Then which one is more closer to x star, optimal point? Alpha equal to 0.2 or alpha equal to 0.1, which one is good?
0.2.
0.2, right? Why 0.2 is good? Okay, this is looking more closer to this one, right? Okay, that's fine. Fast learning, right? Can you call it like fast learning? Suppose if you go for alpha equal to 0.01, what you are going to have is your xk plus 1 is just little bit away from this. This will be your xk plus 1 if alpha equal to 0.01. It's slow learning, right? Slow learning. Your target is you need to approach to this global minimum. That's what your target. You are trying to learn very slowly, right? The fast learning, like that you can think. Okay, which one is good for you? Slow learning or fast learning? Okay, it's already 1 hour, right? Let me close this. Okay, do you have any doubts? Okay, if you have doubts, you can ask me. Yeah, that's fine. Thank you.